Hey everybody! Hello, hello! How are you all today? If you guys could only see my desk right now, you would be shocked because it is a mess. I have like nail polish remover, air freshener, makeup remover, tanning product, deodorant, like... I don't know. Jewelry, earrings, like, it's insane, you guys. And I hate clutter. That's what makes this so much funnier, because I hate clutter. So you would think that my desk would never be cluttered, but it is. Anyways, you guys, what a way to open up a video, right? To start a video. People are gonna be like, what is wrong with this girl? Next. All right, let me put some stuff away here, you guys, and get started with this makeup tutorial or video, whatever you wanna call it, because who am I to give a tutorial, like, really? You know, I'm just here living my best life, enjoying makeup, putting it on my face the best way that I know how, and hoping to God that other people enjoy watching me and think that I do a pretty good job. So anyways, you guys, we are going to do some pharmacy today, and we are going to use the CC primers, because you guys know I love them. So I am going to use a little bit of the green to balance out the red right that I have, like, right here. So we're going to do that first. And then we are going to put on the other one. That was way too much. Really, Charlotte? Like, seriously? Who do I think I am needing all that? Sheesh. I certainly didn't need that much. You guys don't need that much. You don't need that much, you guys. Like, do as I say, don't do as I do. Because that was a way too much product. Luckily, it all blends in. Thank God. Okay, I'm going to put a little bit of the purple one. Okay. Hold on, I need to shake this a moment. Shaky, shaky. Okay, let's try this again. Oh, much better, much better. Okay, so I just kind of go on top of what I already did, add it to the areas that I didn't put any of the green. Now, you can go in with an additional primer if you wanted to, the Stay Matte the mattifying primer, I should say, not the Stay Matte, that's the foundation. But we have a mattifying primer, which is the one in the silver tube, and then we have our strobe primer, which is in the purple tube, and that is the one that I use all the time when I use my pharmacy products, and unfortunately, I don't have that one. I need to order it. I used it up, you guys. So, I have to order a new one. I went to go use it the other day, and I'm like, okay, I have everything but... I don't have the mattifying one, but I don't use the mattifying one. So, I don't need to order that one, but I do need to get the strobe. Okay, so we have our primer on. And what we're going to do today is we are going to make a little concoction, you guys. And I'm going to show you the CC Cream Foundation. This is a color corrector, and it is in the shade light to medium. And we are going to mix a little bit of the calendula oil with it, because I do not like a real thick or full coverage foundation. And even though this is just a CC cream, and most people are used to CC creams that are very lightweight, that don't give a lot of coverage, Ours is totally different, you guys. It's the opposite. It is so full coverage. It is a thicker formula. So, because I don't really like that, I like a thinner, I like to mix the calendula in. And you can do this with any of our foundations. You can do it with our VFX, our Stay Matte, or our BB or CC. So, really good, right? So, this is our CC cream, and that is in the shade, like I said, light to medium. And I'm just going to start off by doing that first. And then, what's left on my finger, I am going to just place a couple of drops into my finger, onto my fingers, I should say. And I'm going to place this. And at first, it's going to look absolutely crazy, but don't you worry. Don't you worry. We are going to blend it all in. And I actually think I'm going to need a darker color. So I'm just placing that everywhere that I need to and want it. And now I'm going to go in with a damp beauty blender and we are going to start to melt that product in. And it is a damp beauty blender. My eyelids, you guys, my allergies have been so bad. So even my eyelids are dry. Like they've been peeling for me. Like rubbing my eyes because they're so itchy. It's crazy. So, again, I'm just bringing that product all the way down my neck. And by using the damp beauty blender, you guys, it adds moisture to my skin. So, it really does make the product very hydrated, which is what my skin requires. And it also thins it out a little bit. So if you didn't want it to thin out and you want that full coverage, go in with a brush, you guys. Go in like a kabuki brush, anything like that. Or you can go with a beauty sponge, but just don't dampen it as much. Because it will thin it out a little bit. But I, just for reference, I have really dry skin, 52, and my skin is, getting more mature. My skin does not match my personality, you guys. I am so silly. I hate to grow up. Like, I should have been a Toys R Us kid because I don't want to grow up. I don't want to get old. I'm like Peter Pan. So, my skin is aging, but up here, I still think I'm 20 years old, okay? But I have mature skin. I have some fine lines and wrinkles. I have some unevenness. I have some melasma. I have some hyperpigmentation. And I have some pores, so like, yeah, we got it all, you guys. It's like a potpourri on my face, but that's okay. You know why? Because it just shows I've lived a life, you guys. I've lived a life. So, because as far as I know, there is no fountain of youth that I can go dunk my body in or my face. So, there's that. Okay, so we are blended and ready to go on to step two, which is gonna be adding some warmth to our skin. Not a whole lot. I don't wanna go too crazy with the contour today. I have places to go, people to see. So, we are going to go easy on the contour, and I will eventually find my contour. It only took three times. So this is our cream contour stick, you guys. And let me get these little baby hairs out. So I am just putting that right there. And do I want it on my, I want to come here. Let's start out with that for now, shall we? And again, you can do this with your damp beauty blender, or you can take your kabuki brush and blend it in with that. Which honestly, I might do at the top because it doesn't really show up as much. So, this is our kabuki brush. This is a pharmacy brush, you guys. And our brushes are so good. You guys know I'm in love with our double-ended brushes. And I love, love, love the kabuki brush. And just a fun fact, it took me, even though I'm an influencer, it took me so long to be able to get this little sucker because it kept selling out all the time. And I'm like, wait a minute. Like, no, you cannot be out. I need you. I need to show you. I need to show people this brush. You need to come back in stock. And finally, it came back in stock. And I'm like, oh, I am not missing out this time. And I ordered five of these suckers. Now, granted, I've given a couple away, but I have two because it is one of the best kabuki brushes that I have used. Just blends out things so nicely. And you can use it for other things. It doesn't mean you just can only use it for contour or bronzing. You can use it for foundation. You can use it pretty much for anything, you guys. Okay. So you can see how pretty. I gotta fix my hair, you guys. This is driving me insane. Hold up. I just washed and dried my hair, so it's like really like soft, like freshly blow dried, so it doesn't want to stay in place. You know, when you have next day hair, it just stays down a lot better. Okay, so you can see how pretty that contour is. It's not going to give you like Oompa Loompa vibes. You know what I mean? Like, you're not going to look like you just stepped off the movie set of Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. Which, I wouldn't mind being on that movie set if it was real stuff that they were eating, but I don't think it was. But, you know, it looked fun. But I didn't want to look like an Oompa Loompa, you know? I don't like that. I'm not into the Oompa Loompa look, so. All right, you guys, now we are gonna go in with some liquid lipstick and we are going to use this as our blush. And then we're gonna go into an eye look, you guys. So I'm placing that on these ham hocks that you've all come to know. These ham hocks, oh my goodness. Good thing I'm like not an animal because the butcher would love me. I got some big cheeks, you guys. Even when I lost like all my weight, my cheeks always stayed so big. It's just like they don't want to leave me. Like they're like, no, we're good here. You can lose weight everywhere else, but we're gonna stay right here. And make your face look like you didn't lose any weight. You know? And I got a pimple coming out right here, so there's that. But it covered it really nicely, so that's good. Okay, so you can add a little bit more, and I might add a little bit more once I do my eye look. Because sometimes it starts out looking perfect, but then I realize you need a little bit more blush. And I'm just making sure that this foundation is nicely blended. And again, you guys, this is a full coverage CC cream. This CC cream is no joke, I'm telling you. is no joke. All right, so I today am going to do, I originally was going to go with some of the single shadows, but I'm starting to wonder if I want to use my Glam Up palette. We have beautiful single eyeshadows, you guys, which don't get talked about a lot, but they're so, so pretty. This is one of my favorite. It's called Taupe, Warm Taupe, and it's so pretty, you guys. If you like neutral, taupey shades, you guys, look at that. It's so pretty. But I think I just did a look for you guys using the taupe. Oh, did I use it? Now I could do purple. Maybe we'll do purple. Maybe we'll do a little purple. Should we do a little purple? Maybe. Let's see. The purples are from the newest shades that we came out with in a bundle. And they are so pretty, you guys. So, so pretty. I kind of wanted to do a nude look though, because I wanted to do a certain lip look with you guys. So I think I am going to go into my Glam Up palette, which I just got my new one in, because I hit pan on the other one, you guys. I was like, wow, I need a new one. So we got a new one. Don't you just love a brand new eyeshadow palette? Oh, you guys, look it. It's so pretty. I love this palette, you guys. You have no idea. This makes me so happy. I love this eyeshadow palette. All right, we are going to start off with a fluffy brush. And I'm going to go into the shade Magnolia, which is a gorgeous matte, almost like a nude, and I love putting this down as my base. And it just kind of sets that foundation. And then everything else that goes on top is going to look perfect. Okay. And another issue that I'm starting to have is, you can see I have a lot of creping on my lids, you guys. And there is nothing I can do about it except make the best of it. So that is what we're going to do. All right, we are going to go in with, I'm going to go in with Buff next. We're going to use a couple of shades. And I am going to work Buff into the crease. And you guys, this palette is good on anybody. So it doesn't matter what skin tone you are, whether you like neutrals or a little bit more bolder looks, because you have the darker shades that you can make these gorgeous, bold, smoky eye looks with. And it's so pretty. So, so pretty, you guys. And then if you just want to keep it really simple and subtle, you have plenty of those shades too. And these are so pigmented, you guys. And they just blend like a dream. So good. I have been loving, like, just trying out different products and different techniques and, like, seeing all the ways that you can just utilize different makeup. It has been so eye-opening for me, no pun intended, but it has, like, I am so amazed at, like, how you can incorporate different products together and how some products will do different things for you and some will work better than others, but that you can mix and match even if it's like not the same brand. Like, I have just been loving experimenting with makeup. Like, it's just been so fun, you guys. Like, just to sit down and just put makeup on to just show you guys and just be like showing you different ways. It's just been so fun. I'm just having a grand old time doing it. And I know sometimes it confuses people if you like use more than one brand or you represent one company, but you like to try other things, that sometimes it gets confusing, but in the end, you know, in the end, it's all about makeup and just having fun and showing products that are good for a variety of people, not just one type of person. Like, I don't like to be locked into like one thing. Like, I want options. Like, I want options, you know? So, I am having the best time. All right, I'm gonna go in with Warm Teddy now, and I'm going to stop placing that on my outer corner. So I have just been like absolutely having the time of my life trying out different products and also like coming up with new eye looks, because I kind of got stagnant for a while, you guys. I was doing the same looks like over and over, and I'm like, Charlotte, you gotta step it up a notch. Like, you gotta change your eye look around a little bit and come up with some new looks, because people don't want to see the same look on you every time. You know, when you get into that comfort zone and you just like, I don't know, you get like comfortable in one thing, and then it's like you find yourself like doing that over and over again. So I'm like, no, girl, you need to come out of your box and do some new looks. So once the new palette came in, my new glam up, I'm like, okay, all my shades are back. Because when I tell you I hit pan on this palette, I hit pan. I hit pan on Magnolia, Dusty Rose, my Nefertiti, Warm Taupe. Like, the taupe was totally gone. Warm Teddy, Reyna. I mean, I had literally hit pan. So I'm like, okay, we're gonna order a new one and we are gonna come up with some new looks. And that's what I've been doing, like playing and just like taking my hand and putting colors on my hand to try to represent my eye. And like, okay, put this under the brow bone, this on the lid, and just blending it out. And also like practicing my techniques so that I get better and better, you know? So now we have that. So I'm gonna go in with Nefertiti, which is this gorgeous like gold. And this is the other favorite. It's Reyna. It's so pretty, you guys. So I am going to put Nefertiti right here. Isn't that gorgeous, you guys? Oh my God. It's so pretty. It's so pretty, you guys. It's like my favorite color in this palette, honestly. I just love this because it's great on its own, but it makes such a beautiful copper shade also. It's like this gorgeous, gorgeous shimmer. Oh my God. I guess I am excited. Can't talk. It's just a gorgeous shimmer shade. Like, it's just so pretty, but it's like very it's weird because it's beautiful, but it almost appears translucent. Like, it just like people look at it like, okay, what is that? It doesn't look like an eyeshadow, but we see this gorgeous glow, and I think people are like, oh, wait a minute, how's she doing that? It's just so pretty, you guys. Okay, now I am going to take my little tiny brush and I'm going to go into Warm Teddy, and we're going to mimic what we did on the top. So we're going to take that Warm Teddy and put it right on the outer portion of that lower lid. We're not taking it all the way across, okay? We're not going to take it all the way because we're going to mimic what we did up here. And then I'm going to wipe my brush off. And then we're gonna go in with buff. And we're gonna put that on the inner part of the eye. And try not to get the brush in your eye like I just did, because it hurts. Because if I was to bring that dark shadow all the way across to my inner corner, my eye would look so closed off, you guys. It would not be good. So now, we're gonna go in with Gold Tail. And I'm gonna pop that on the inner corner. Okay. And Gold Tail is this gorgeous, gorgeous gold. It's like a champagne gold almost. It's so pretty, you guys. Look at that. And I'm telling you guys, if you have blue eyes, this look is so good for that. It's just going to bring out your eyes so much. Okay, now we're gonna go in with some highlighter, because we didn't put any highlight on, you guys. What was I thinking? Gotta have highlight. As soon as I find it, you guys, where's my highlight? You guys, what is going on here? Why can I not find my highlight? I'm a hot mess today, you guys. I am just a hot mess. I have no idea where my highlighter went. Here it is. Oh boy, it's gonna be one of those days, you guys. It's gonna be like, why are we watching this girl? She has no idea what she's doing. Okay, this is the 3-in-1 face palette. I'm just using the highlighter from that. And I am putting that on, and then I'm gonna go back in and blend it a little bit, because this highlighter is so intense, you guys, that it needs a little toning once you put it on. So I'm going to go in with that damp beauty blender, and I'm going to just melt that into my skin so that it looks a little more natural. My camera's crooked now. See how beautiful that is, you guys? Oh my God, look at that. Like, the angels can see me coming a mile away. And that's either a good thing or a bad thing. I'm not too sure which. All right. Oh, it's so good. Okay. Next, we're going to do mascara, because that's the most important thing. I'm sorry. That just is. You have to have a good mascara, you guys. If you don't, you are missing out. So I am going to use the Zen, which is enriched with vitamin E. It's $8.90, you guys. $8.90. I kid you not. Like, and it is so, so good. This is the wand. So you've got like shorter bristles on the bottom and then taller on the top. And you guys, when I tell you that this mascara does everything, it does everything. It gives you length, volume, separation, everything. And it's $8.90, you guys. That's so flippin' cheap. It's so affordable. Like, when you can get affordable products that are high quality, like, that is so good. Because, like, some mascaras are cheap, but they're cheap in quality. Like, they're just cheap all the way around. Ours are affordable, but they're not cheap in quality or ingredients. And the vitamin E is going to strengthen your lashes and really help them. So if you have, like, brittle lashes that you're trying to get back to a good place, You will love Zen. So I am just placing that, and I have not dipped back in. I'm just fanning these out. Look at that, you guys. Can you see that? This difference? Isn't that incredible? And it's such an easy, easy mascara to use. The wand is really user-friendly, which I find important because there's a lot of people, believe it or not, that do not know how to use mascara or never have. And they go to use a mascara and it's like a wand that's like really hard to use or too big or too bulky. And they make a mess and then they're like, oh, I'm just not doing this ever again. And then they just stop using the mascara. Like they'll just not even try because the one that they picked, the wand was just way too hard to use and wasn't like user friendly. Because believe it or not, you know, people make fun, but if you don't know, if you've never used mascara or you've never tried putting a mascara on, it can be daunting, you guys. It can, like, you know, this is no joke. Some people do not do well with mascara, especially if it's a bigger wand. And especially for people that have issues with anything being near their eye to begin with, it's even harder. Like, I know people that will constantly shut their eye. Every time they go to go do a coat, it's like their eyes are blinking and like they're panicking because they think it's going to get in their eye, like the brush is going to hit their eye, and they get so nervous. But this is so lightweight. Like the applicator itself is so lightweight and it's just so easy. You have enough of the handle of a handle to hold on to whichever way you want. I mean, believe it or not, some people do this to keep their hands steadier, but I just go like that. But the wand itself is so versatile, and like I said, it's super easy to work with. And the mascara has enough time on it that you can work with it before it dries down completely. So then on the bottom lashes, I go with the shorter bristle side so that I'm not making a mess. I put that first. And then I kind of just wiggle my wand back and forth to get all those lashes. And I have gone back to using my Pharmacy Lash Serum because I noticed such a big difference in my lashes when I stopped using it because I had run out. And I just was like, ah, my lashes are good. You know, I'll wait. I'll hold off on ordering it. I don't need it right now. Well, a couple of months went by, you guys, and I just didn't order it. My eyelashes became so bad again, you guys. It took me so long to get them to where I wanted. And the minute I stopped using the serum, I noticed a difference. And then after a couple of months, like, you could really tell a difference. Like, really. And it was not good. My lashes were, like, breaking. They weren't full anymore. They didn't have volume anymore. And especially my lower lashes, like, you guys can tell, like, there's a huge difference. I have hardly any lashes at the bottom now, and I had finally gotten up to all, like, look really full, and they were looking so good. So I am back to using the serum, and I will never not use it now because I know for a fact, like 100%, that it does work. And it has Capixel in it. It's just really, really good. I am making a mess on this side because I have very few lashes now on the bottom. You can tell, like, I'm just struggling because I really don't have that many. I have more on this eye than this eye. So I'm gonna let that dry, you guys, and then I'm gonna just go in with my little brush and I will take that off, but I'm gonna let it dry first. But you guys can see like how incredible this mascara is, and it's $8.90, you guys, so worth it. And we have other mascaras, and I love them all, to be honest with you. There's none that I don't like, really, but I do have my favorites. I really do have my favorites, so I tend to stick with my favorites. So now we're going to go in with lips, and I am going to go in and do, let's see, that's the other thing I have to get. I need to get, I need to restock on my, my liquid matte lipsticks, because I'm running low, you guys. I'm running low. Okay, we're gonna line with 227. It's like a dark chocolate brown. And I will tell you, so many of the girls on my pharmacy team, like on our team, love this combo. And it's funny because it looks different on every one of us. And the lip pencils are so good, you guys. And they're so affordable. Super, super affordable. And I'm gonna fill in these corners. Because the director of my team did this today, and it made such a huge difference. Like, I've always used 227 in this color that I'm going to use, but I never thought to fill in like the corners, and it made such a huge difference. Like, her lips just looked so much more plump. So I am going to do the same. Okay. So now I'm going to go in with Cool Girl, which is one of our liquid matte lipsticks. And I am concentrating it mainly in the center. And this is another color, you guys, that looks so different on everyone. Like, it looks so different on all of us. It really just does depends on, I think, the lip color that you have, like your natural lip color. But that's what it looks like on my hand. And it's so pretty, you guys. It's so, so pretty. And then I am going to, let's see, I'm gonna go in with the lightest pink that I have. And I am going to place that right in the center and blend that out. I'm just kind of tapping it. And then I just kind of do that. And see how pretty that is? It just kind of lightens it. But it doesn't take away from the lip liner or anything like that. You still have that beautiful ombre. And it's just so pretty. Okay. And I'm just darkening the corners up a little bit. And just Isn't that gorgeous, you guys? I love, love, love this combo. I've always done this combo, but I just never thought to, need to get one of my Scentsy wipes. I never thought to like build it up in the corners. You know what I mean? It's so pretty, you guys. So that is, oh, and that's the color I just used in the center. Look how pretty that is. It's like a milky pink. So good, you guys. And I need more Scentsy wipes. These are amazing, you guys. If you love using makeup wipes, you need these. They are so affordable and they are alcohol free. There's no parabens in them and they take off everything. Like, I never not have these in stock in my house. I always, always, always have these around. Now, if you wanted to make this a little bit more glowy, you could go in with one of our lip glosses. And this one is still one of my favorites. It's the Miss Sparkle Lip Gloss. And it's the peach-based one. I think it's number 2. Mine has worn off, so I don't remember. But I'm pretty sure it's number 2. And you can go right in the center. I don't take it over the entire lip. I just bring it into the middle. And look at that, you guys. Is that not beautiful? And it complements my eyes because it has a little bit of shimmer that's similar to what we have on the eyes. So this is the combo that I love, love, love when I have like an eye like this. Even if I just have mascara sometimes, I will put this on because it's just so, so pretty, you guys. So that is the look, you guys. I think we did everything. Did we do everything? Yes, we did. So let me recap what we did because I was a hot mess express today. I don't even know why anybody's watching me today. You guys probably already logged off this video. Let's keep it real because I just was all over the place. But that's real life, you guys. Like, that's just real life. So I'm keeping it real. And I haven't been on in a while. I haven't done a video in a while. So gotta get back on the wagon, back on the bike, back on the horse, whatever. You know the sayings. Once you get, you know, once you never forget how to ride a horse or a bike. Isn't that a saying? I don't know. But anyways, we started off with our CC primers, the VFX CC primers. We had the green and the purple. So we used both because I'm fancy like that. Then we went in with our BB cream in light to medium. I mean, I'm sorry, we did CC. I always use BB, so I'm so used to it, but I wanted to show you the color correcting one. So CC in light to medium. Again, it's a thicker formula. It is going to give you full coverage, you guys. This is no joke, okay? Like, it is no joke, okay? A little goes a long way, and you get definite payoff, okay? Just so you actually see on my hand. But it still gives you that pretty glow. Now, I do not set my face with powders, but you guys can. But I never set my face with powder because it would look so dry if I did that. So you can see the coverage. Like, it's incredible. And that's a CC cream, you guys. Like, that is so, so good. Like, you know, and it's buildable. So you can do a little or a little bit more and just build it up. But you definitely can see, I mean, look at the coverage. Look at the difference between that hand and that one. Like, it works, you guys. It works. This is like a no joke CC cream. So that's what we did, light to medium. Then we went in with the Glam Up palette and we did our eyes. We did the shades Magnolia as a base. Then we went in with Buff. And then we went in with Warm Teddy. And we did Nefertiti and a little bit of Gold Tail in the corner. Then we did 227 lip liner with Cool Girl liquid matte lipstick and a little bit of the Miss Sparkle lip gloss on top in the peach shade, which I think is number 2. And then we did, what else did we do? Oh, we did contour with our cream contour stick. And it's just one shade, you guys, so it's universal. I'm just cleaning off that mascara that we got underneath. So it's just one shade. And then we used our 3-in-1 palette for our highlight. We used a lipstick, a bullet style lipstick as our blush. You can pick whatever shade you want. And that's a really good trick, you guys. If you like more cream products, go with your CC cream, buy a bullet style lipstick, out of any shade that you like out of the catalog that you would like to use as a blush shade, and then use that. Use the cream contour, use the cream highlight stick, okay? Because we have a cream contour. We also have another cream product, and I really like this and the cream contour sometimes just to do as my foundation. It's really, really nice. You can just blend it all together and it makes this incredible foundation base. This is our cream highlighter, you guys. It's super pretty. So you can go in with a lot of these products and do a full cream, you know, face if you are more into cream products. And then just do, you can actually use some of our liquid eyeshadows, or you can use any of the powdered shadows. But if you just want to keep your main part of your face more creamy, dewy looking, then just stick with the cream products. And then, like I said, you can always mix the calendula oil in with any foundation to give it a little bit more dewiness and a glowy look to it. It will thin it out a little bit. And also using a damp beauty blender will help to thin that out and really just add that hydration into your skin, so your skin will look so, so pretty. We have several shades, you guys, of foundation. We have several mascaras. Today we used our Zen mascara, which has vitamin E. It's $8.90. So it is an amazing, amazing mascara. Our lip products, you guys know, they are so, so good. They're not gonna crumble on you. They're not gonna dry. They're very comfortable to wear all day, and they're long lasting, you guys. So these are such a steal. Some of them are $11.90, some are $19.90. Actually, my favorite ones are actually part of the original liquid lip matte lipsticks that we had. These are some of my favorites, you guys. The formula is just bomb. Like, it's so good. But then we have the VFXs, which are $19.90. But the originals are still, I believe, not $11.90. So worth it, you guys. They are so, so good. Like, this shade is one of my favorites. It's Wild Rose. And it's so pretty, you guys. Look at that. Like, look at the pigment on that. Is that not incredible? And like I said, they go on like a liquid form, and then they dry down to a matte finish. And you can blend these out and blur them out and ombre them out while they're wet. And then once you do that, let it sit, and it will stay on for hours, you guys, hours. Even with eating and drinking, they will stay on. So this is our Kabuki brush. You know I love this brush. If you want it, you can get that off the website. And the highlight we used, like I said, it was from the 3-in-1 palette. This is the shade we used, that highlight right there. So I hope you guys like this look. I am so happy with it. This is still one of my favorite looks, and I think because it brings out my eyes so much that I just love it. So anyways, you guys, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you all have a great day. If you would like to shop for any of the products that you saw me use today, you can do so at www.pharmacyus.com/CharlotteCardoso2. If you have any questions at all, feel free to message me. I will answer any questions that you have, and I can also help you build a customized skincare regimen or a makeup regimen. So don't hesitate to ask. That's what I'm here for. And just have fun, you guys. Have fun. Try different products. Try different things. even with the same brand, try different things and think outside of the box. Think of new ways that you can reinvent products that you've been using that you kind of maybe got bored with. Come up with new ways to use them and new eye looks and things like that. Go on Pinterest, watch other YouTubers or beauty influencers and get fresh new ideas and fall back in love with the products that you've been loving and just have fun with it, you guys. That's all I can say. Like, that's what's happening with me now. I'm falling back in love with products that I had gotten stagnant with because I just felt like I ran out of ways to use them or ran out of ideas. And now it's like I'm coming up with all these new look, eye looks and lip looks and ways to use products and remembering that, oh, wait a minute, you can use this product for that. And oh, I forgot you can do this with that. And just getting excited again and like just having fun again. And that's so good because makeup should be fun. It should make you feel good. So not stressed out. So yeah. All right, you guys, I'm not gonna take any more of your time. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you for watching it to the end if you did. And I will leave the link of everything below. And you can always click on my link tree and go to any of the places that you need to go to shop for these. It will send you directly to where you can buy any of these items or just go by and click on and look and see what each site has to offer. And go from there, just browse, like do some window shopping, you know what I mean? So, and as always, if you refer me out to friends and family, I really do appreciate that so much, you guys, and it really does help me. So even if you don't buy from me, if you refer me out to friends and family, that's always a huge, huge help. So, all right, you guys, this was so much fun, and hopefully I'll get better and better with these videos. It's been a while, so I gotta get back in the groove, but I wanna bring you a ton of content, you guys, so. So I will be always thinking of things to do and hopefully, like I said, I'll get better and better and you guys will enjoy watching me even more. So, all right, you guys, love you guys. Bye.